Impmas.
Yeah.
Impmas. Yes. Christmas. Don't know what this Christmas Impmas. Stuff is
this
all about.
Christ.
Yes.
It's
who
all
knows?
About the imp.
Christ knows. Yes, it
bottle
is all
imp
about
Christmas special.
The bottle imp. Yes, it's all about he's drunk already. It's all about Grocklesnook. He is
aren't
drunk.
We all?
We're all drunk. My name is Ken Boyter, and this crumpus of a person is Julian.
Oh, hello.
Oh, yes. And together we are the Bottled Imp. Thank you so much for joining us. This is
it's Christmas Day.
It is Christmas Day.
This is
Day.
What we do on Christmas yeah. Day, literally.
Well,
we
live together, so
we're
why not?
We're sitting here. This yeah. is our house.
Yeah, we've just got out of bed.
Here, and we just sat down and we thought, I tell you what, let's share our Christmas yeah. with you lot.
You lot, fellow imps,
anyway,
yes.
Because
what we're going to do is, apart from eating lots of stuff, what you normally do at Christmas time or the festival season is eat, obviously. You've got the mince pies.
The festival season.
The festival season.
Is that the
right word? No,
like,
festive.
Like summer is the festival season.
Yeah.
When you go to concerts
this is,
and stuff.
Yeah. Oops. This is just a winter one.
Okay.
Yeah. Festival
festive
is coming.
Season festive. Makes more sense.
It does. But you know I don't make any sense.
No.
Mince
doing?
Pies. Got mince pies. Mince these pie. Are vegetarian. So I think they're, no, they're vegan.
Vegan.
They're vegan. Should we try one of these first?
Whoa.
This is for our American viewers because they don't have mince pies.
Mine's just falling apart already.
Yeah,
what?
That's
struggling.
Vegan for you. Look at that, perfect.
There's no suet in the pastry.
Is that what it is?
Or whatever it is.
But look,
fact.
This is, I got a perfect one.
Oh yeah, I just destroyed mine. Yeah. Should we go in?
Yeah.
Mmm, Christmassy.
That's actually pretty good.
Yeah, I'm very sweet.
Sorry,
and
they
sickly.
Are very yeah.
They're just a lot of sugar.
A lot of sugar.
There is fruit in there, but it's cleverly disguised with lots and lots of sugar.
Mm. Yeah, it's not mince, for those of you who think. I used to think it was mince. As a kid, I used to think it was
yeah,
mince.
Well, yeah. I think they used to be made with mince meat or
probably.
Something. I could be wrong. Who knows?
Yeah. Yeah, it's probably dog.
Whoa.
Dog meat.
That was nice.
Mm. Tell me about that. I've got loads of these. So I'll be eating those. Also, Christmas Yule log. I always think it's like Dougal from The Magic Roundabout.
Well, it's very similar to Colin the Caterpillar. It's basically the same principle. Yeah, it's just a birthday cake. This is a Christmas thing. It's just
are we
it's re-skinned.
Are we watching The Grinch?
It's just re-skinned.
Yeah.
This is going to roll off if I don't eat
well,
it quickly.
Yeah, you eat it. It's, again, vegetarian.
Super.
Yeah. I thought I'd show this off because the shop that I went to didn't have... they only had one type. It was a very small shop. And it was a sort of luxury one. £3.50.
Oh, you're spoiling us.
I know.
Crabboids
so
are spoiling us on
it.
Christmas.
Yeah. And, oh, so what we're going to do is, yes,
before
we go
we've got to
yeah.
crack on. Because
we're going to do?
Always with the time.
I know.
Even on Christmas Day. We've got to crack on because we've got to celebrate Christmas.
Yeah.
We've got to go and watch the
we
Queen's speech.
We never relax, do we? Go watch the Queen's speech, of course.
What we're doing today in this special festive extra episode on Christmas Day, it's not even a Friday.
No, I think what we're going to be doing is we are going to be doing stick or twist. Stick or twist,
stick
Julian.
Or twist.
Stick
we're
or twist.
Stick or twist.
Yeah. We have...
festive looking parcels.
Yes. Three envelopes.
Colourful, festive parcels.
All right. This is all I had. In my stationery cupboard. All right. I'm not okay. W.H. Smith's. Mm. I've got a selection. So, yeah. Pretend they're Christmassy and they've got Christmas drawings on them.
Should we explain what we're going to do?
Yeah.
We're
that's what
like,
I'm doing.
Okay, go on. Go for it. Well, you're just showing the finish.
Yeah, I'm showing the...
Okay.
So what we're doing
what's
is...
what's in there?
Well, these are films. DVDs. This is Christmas Impmas. Stick or twist. So what's going to happen is I know what's in there, obviously. One of us had to. But I've not seen any of these films. I don't know if Julian's seen any of these. We didn't discuss this. We didn't plan this. This is going to be a mystery to Julian. There are clues.
Ooh. Oh, clues, okay.
So they're clues.
Okay, cool.
You get to pick one.
Okay.
You get to open it.
Yeah.
You can then choose. Yay, let's watch this one. Or pick
move
another
on.
One.
Okay.
But if you do that, that one that you first picked, you can't go back
can
to
never
it.
Go back.
Can't go back.
Can never go back.
And then we'll proceed from there. You
okay.
can pick another one. Stick or twist. Stick okay. or twist. Stick or twist.
Never have a re-vote. Never go back.
Never go back.
Once
you
a decision's been made,
it's,
you're stuck with it for the rest of your
yeah.
life.
Even if it's detrimental
yeah.
to yourself.
To yourself.
And
fair.
Others.
It's democracy.
That is democracy
it's not
in
actually
action.
Democracy.
No,
yeah,
it's not democracy.
Like, anyway.
But it is democracy.
Political.
Topical.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
there we go. So... just
okay.
want to point out though.
And then do we explain that then we sit and watch the film, you don't
yes.
watch it because
oh, yeah.
you can't sit and just sit here watching
yeah.
it. That'd be a very boring episode.
Well, no, they're good. They're good.
Well, just us sitting and watching a film and
yeah.
then just watching
welcome
us watching
to the basement.
It. It's a little bit Big Brother.
Hello.
So we'll sit and watch it and eat all this healthy food.
Yep.
And then we'll come back after and tell you what we thought of it.
Yeah, that's the
whole point.
You can
go away and
yeah.
dig it out and watch it yourself.
Exactly.
And that's how these work.
What are you going to be drinking?
That? I'll probably have a nice cup of green tea, which I shall make in a minute.
On Christmas Day?
Oh, no, Christmas Day. It's Christmas Day, isn't it? I should be having a Baileys and a glass of red wine.
Of course you will. I've gone for King Goblin, 6.6% alcohol.
You love Goblin, don't you?
I do love that. And it's an extraordinary beer of exceptional quality.
Yeah.
And it's only brewed on a full moon.
Is it? So, okay. It must be expensive.
I don't know whose full moon that it's brewed on, but it is brewed on a full moon.
Okay.
So,
okay, let's
I feel like I'm missing something else. Oh, no, we've got the presents. What
oh,
we
we've got
to do?
Presents.
Yeah, we've got presents.
Should we do this, choose the film, then give each other our Christmas presents? We're like Bert and Ernie.
Yeah, exactly.
And then, because then we can,
yeah,
we can look
okay,
forward to what.
Let's
do this. This is the crux of the episode.
Okay, yeah, right. Here we go then.
Okay. What
so,
I love a movie.
The first one,
I
these
don't
aren't
often
in any...
love our Christmas movies that we watch, but I love a movie. Okay.
I'm going to mix
Should
these
I pick
up.
One?
No, I'm going to read out the clues.
Oh, okay.
So, first clue. Not your normal stocking filler.
Okay. No, not much of a clue there.
Not really. Couldn't really think of anything.
Okay. And are these clues give me a hint as to what the film is?
They should do. Okay. They should do. They're very... Have you said you 3, 2, 1? They're basically impossible to work out.
Okay, right.
Hopefully, this won't pass slowly on the festive on this festive season.
Okay.
See, I even put festival there. As
okay.
Well.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Okay.
And the third one is this pig could be your dad. So we've got not your normal stocking filler.
Okay.
Hopefully, this won't pass slowly on this
None
festive
of those
season.
Are helping me at all.
This pig could be your dad.
So. These are all Christmas-related
all Christmas
and fantasy-related films. See, I'm surprised you managed to pull three out of the bag, because we've done a few of these, and it can't be that hot, easy to find fantasy Christmas-related films.
Well, to be honest, on an open caveat, Christmas is fantasy anyway, isn't it?
Oh, that's a... I'm going to go, because I'm having a guess at what this is, but I'm probably wrong, so I don't get the dad reference, but you've mentioned pig, so I might just go with that one and then dismiss it straight away. Because I obviously want to just choose one straight away.
Okay.
So I might risk doing that.
You're going for that one? Okay.
I hope it's not one I want to see.
Okay. He's going for this. What's it? This pig could be your dad.
Mmm.
Yeah, smelling it will give you extra clues as well.
Okay.
Pig flavoured.
Hogfather. Hogfather.
See what I did there with the clue?
Yes, Hogfather. Terry Pratchett's
Have you heard
Hogfather.
It?
No, not
no.
heard of it. Not
so
seen
did
it.
You know what it was?
Not at
no.
all. I thought it was like. Pig in the City, or what was that?
Babe
Pig in the City. I thought you might have pushed... That's sort of fantasy
it's,
talking.
Yeah, but it's not Christmas, though, is it?
I can't remember. It probably takes place over Christmas.
I don't know.
Okay. Oh, okay, tricky. Okay.
Now, this one, though, bit of a caveat. This one is about 3 hours long.
Okay, so no, we can't do that. We just don't have the time to watch it and film the response afterwards. Because it's Christmas.
Delayed.
We've got to watch the Christmas.
We've got stuff to do.
We've got, yeah.
So you want to go for another one?
Pass on that one.
Okay.
You can never go back.
Yeah.
Okay.
We'll save that for next year.
Yeah.
I'll just wrap it up again.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, so now I'm
so you've got not your normal stocking filler, or hopefully this won't pass slowly on this festive season.
Okay, this sounds like it could be a tedious watch, because you mentioned slowly. That's got a word stocking in it, so it could be a little bit more interesting.
Okay.
This is what I'm basing these on. So I'm going to go for this one.
Okay.
Because obviously, you know.
You're going to eliminate
it.
Oh, okay,
this
I hadn't
one.
Thought you'd do that.
Yeah,
clever way of playing it.
Yeah, because I want to, you know, you've got to go through.
You eliminate
I might
it.
Not eliminate it if it's
of
good.
Course. Yeah.
The Christmas Dragon.
So the clue?
The Christmas...
Pass
slowly on.
Which means
dragon.
It's going to drag on!
The Christmas Dragon.
Do you want to watch
okay.
it? Or do you want to pass?
Follow the magic.
Stick That's twist, stick twist.
Well, it's either got to be so... Oh, yeah. It just looks really awful.
I've not seen it.
It
I didn't
really
read it.
Awful.
I just saw the cover.
I'm going to... I'm going to have to go on and hope for the
You're
best, because that one...
okay.
I know that's just probably going to be terrible, and therefore probably fun. Okay.
So, we've got not your normal
you
stocking
know what this
filler.
Is, so let's go. Oh dear, what a terrible mistake.
I don't know.
Oh no, a horror Christmas story, excellent.
Yes.
I was hoping we'd get a nice horror one.
But
we sometimes get horror one.
We
have we to
do
a Christmas horror
it
one,
It is.
And, they're always terrible.
Yeah. But the beautiful thing about this, well, I won't tell you unless
it looks
you see
like it could be a subtitle.
Not well. Your normal stocking filler. I couldn't think of any clue, and I thought horror I know. Yeah, horror. I looked up what horror means, and it means shocking. And I went, oh, that sounds like stocking. So I thought, stocking filler.
I suppose to help me, the clue.
It's 3, 2, 1. Nobody okay, wants to.
This looks
clues.
Very similar to many other of these type of films. So this is more appropriate. I think we've chosen the right one.
I think you have. I think you have.
You know, we like, and you're more of a horror fan. I'm more of a horror fan. You don't like the horror.
No,
so
but
much.
I quite like watching the Christmas
ones. I've got a DVD
ones.
We're going to watch today. I've talked about it many Ooh. Times. We must watch it as an extra. It's yes. not Christmas rated, but it's. I bought it
next year.
Okay, good. Yeah. I think we've chosen. It's only a 15. That's always disappointing when there's a horror and it's a 15. It's not an 18.
And already he's know. Complaining.
Yeah, because you just, you know. Although you no, get away with a lot more with a 15 now than you used to when I was 15.
There is a boost. I'll take it away from you now, just in case you see what I didn't want you to see. But, well, it'd be a nice surprise for you. But when I saw what I saw, I went, ooh, I do want to watch this.
Okay.
So there you go. So in a second, we'll be watching A Christmas Horror Story. Stay tuned for that.
Good.
But first...
I've got something for you.
Yeah, I happen to have something Whoa. For you as well. So there we go.
Here we go. Hastily wrapped.
Three each.
That's
that. The magic number.
Oh, I just won.
Yeah.
That would have been embarrassing.
It would have been. Right.
Do you want to go with this one first?
Okay, you do that one. Do you want
to
do
that gift.
One?
Okay, I'll hold that. You open it.
Okay,
this
thank
is a
you.
Gift, but I was also sort of thinking...
That you would like it.
No, I was thinking you could go away and film yourself.
Hello.
Like you like to do in the live shows that we do, in the Bottle Imp show we do.
Okay.
You like to go and film yourself with an activity. So
doing
I thought,
stuff.
Here's a festive activity for you to do later on Christmas Day. And you can film yourself doing it. It will be incredibly dull for anyone to watch this film you make. And in fact, all the films you make are incredibly technically difficult to put in the show. Because you film at some bizarre Ken Boyd.
I know, we've got to work that out.
Frame rate. But,
Christmas jumper. Create your own Christmas
create
jumper.
Create your own Christmas jumper.
But so I'm assuming it's
you're
cooking.
Artistic.
Is it cooking?
No, I think they're just made and you just I presume you just decorate.
Oh, you decorate it,
I think they're all there. All you do is you decorate the jumper with the icing.
It
and
says,
fondant.
Need icing pouch for 1 minute to soft smooth
soften
consistency.
Soften it up, squeeze it out. You're quite artistic. I've seen your artwork on the page.
Artistic?
I expect some dramatic...
Autistic.
Yeah, a bit of both. Some dramatic fantasy landscape on the jumper.
Maybe dragon or something.
Yeah,
okay.
Go for it.
I will give it my best shot. And the good thing about this as well, 25 pence from every purchase will go to the NSPCC.
There you go.
So you've done your bit.
There you go.
You've done for a bit.
Brilliant.
Thank you very much.
Do that. I expect to see three. Yeah. I suppose you get three in there. Well, three lovely fantasy-related Christmas-type jumpers.
I'll do a little diary.
Just post it to the fellowship. We don't need to do a show. Post the video straight to Facebook. Join the Facebook channel.
Join the Facebook group, Ooh. Which is the...
This looks like it could be similar to the same thing.
Yeah, exactly. I know you like to decorate.
I've not been
cakes.
Timing this at all. I hope the camera's still rolling.
Who knows?
That's a good bit. You've got some good tape.
Do you want some scissors?
No one opens presents with scissors.
That is true. That is true. I'm going to finish
the
next
time. Yeah, I'm liking it, because I'm not having any lunch. There's no seam. It's just one continuous piece of...
Yeah. Oh. That's how good I am.
Yes.
Julian loves
It's interesting that Ken is really, really promoting this game, the other Bottle Loop game, more than our own Bottle Loop game that failed its Kickstarter.
Yeah.
You know, so...
Well, the thing is...
You could have got me our Bottle Loop game... I don't even have a copy of it.
No,
you've given your friends copies of it.
No, because she's got kids and they were hungry for games. No, they really like playing it, so I thought.
I like playing it too.
Well, I've not played that, but I did order myself. In fact, that was my copy, and I thought, you could get a copy.
You.
Because it is meant to be a good game, and it'd be interesting. I thought it's the sort of game, because it's quick and easy to pick up and learn.
Much like our Bottle Imp game,
yeah, exactly.
Okay.
That you should enjoy it, because you do quite like the old
card games. Oh, I don't mind playing some games. Yeah. I'm not averse to games.
This
one doesn't have much time for games.
Yeah, exactly.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, so be interested to
hear
your... I feel
cheating and dirty, though.
What's that? Oh, yeah, because it's not
our game. Yeah. It's the game that's...
That's just you in general.
Yeah. Thank you.
Cool.
Lovely. Okay, Do I pull it?
Yeah, no, don't do that. Right, look at this. This isn't a bottle of wine, is it?
That is not a bottle of wine. No. Well, I emptied the bottle of wine into that because I needed the bottle.
Let's have a look. Hey!
There you go.
Thank you so much. Look at that.
There you go.
I'm decorating my house.
Yeah.
And I've got the tricky varnishing to do.
Yeah.
Got the paint. No, this is... I have taken up doing my oil painting again. I just hadn't had time to do it recently.
I've given in, I need scissors.
You need scissors.
Your wrecker, you've I've beaten got, me.
Where's the scissors? I don't know where I put them. I've got a big knife. And I've started doing my oil paint again, talking. And I've been doing Christmassy. Yeah, exactly.
Let's not do that.
That is a Christmas horror story right there. And so, when I went back to my paint, I forgot that I left my brushes uncleaned, the schoolboy era. So some of the brushes were a bit manky and I needed some new brushes.
There you go.
So yeah, so I'm going to be doing some more.
It's as if fantasy. I read your mind.
Yeah, exactly.
Or went on your Amazon wish list.
Yeah, probably that one.
I'm just going to rip into this because I can't actually get into this and we really don't have much time. We've got film to watch.
Thank you. I want to do at least
two. Oh
my
God, even the paper is super strong.
Or you're just very weak. He's going to get his penknife out. Oh. See, Boy Scout. Through and through. I'm going to be doing at least two paintings over Christmas holiday.
Yeah, well, you've been churning them out, haven't you?
I've been knocking them out. Well, I just really, once I get into the zone, like you, once you get into stuff. No, not again. I'm going to save that for the film.
Okay. The anticipation is killing me.
I know. I'm hoping it's chocolate.
Oh, because we haven't got enough chocolate.
Here we go.
Snow globe and a picture. Oh my God.
You'll have to get a closer for that one at some point.
Yeah, okay, lovely.
Look at that.
And there's us.
Why wouldn't you want a picture of me on your mantelpiece?
Why wouldn't you? Us pulling a cracker.
Pulling the cracker.
You won't see that, it'll be out of focus.
Yeah, but
it's actually
is.
Quite hard to see in there anyway.
Yeah, but it will. You know, when it settles down.
Truly frightening.
It is quite scary, isn't it?
Thank you very much. You know how I love a dust catcher?
Well, that's what I thought. It fulfills all your criteria, doesn't it? It's a dust catcher. It's pointless.
Yeah.
And it's a picture of me grinning back at you.
I've got to put it somewhere. It's landfill. It will never, ever rot away.
And it's plastic, yeah.
Yeah.
It's brilliant.
Look at that.
But I have got some of these. They were only £1. They're on special.
So no expense spared?
Yeah.
Okay.
But I got about 5 of them, because I'm going to do that for friends and family.
Lord. I feel sorry.
Do you feel
what I'll do is I'll shake it and we'll film just a close-up of that.
Yeah.
And we'll just, that'll just go out an hour.
Yeah.
With a bit of every music, now and again, tinkly, tinkly music. Great, do us some tinkly, tinkly.
Yeah.
Well, thank you. Actually, I'd like to say thank you.
I was going to open this for myself, but no.
Oh no, that's you. Okay, yeah. I'm going to put this away. Do
that's
I need that?
That's quite all right. You probably won't, well, keep it open. It's not. You call that a knife? Here we go. So,
okay. So, well, you should open this one first.
I think, yeah.
Thank you very much. Oh, this is going to be more like it. We already know.
The real present.
Yeah, we just watched this.
Well, you know, I'm tempted, yeah. Right, here we go. Oh, I do like a thick one, so to speak. Look at that.
There we go.
My kin, my fellow friends, my fellow family. Dwarfs.
You're already straightening out that bent corner.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, I must have dropped it. Or not bought it new.
Got it. Yeah.
I don't know. I think it wasn't available new and it was only available secondhand.
It's fine.
Or
you're just
it was a real bargain secondhand. And new, it was a bit like.
I buy secondhand books all the time.
Yeah, well, why not? Get them reread. It's all eco,
isn't it?
It's
passing the love on. That's what I do.
Yeah.
In fact, sometimes I leave books in park benches.
Yeah. There were some pages that were a bit glued, but I moved them. I don't know. Obviously, it gets a bit feisty.
Hopefully, that all the pages are there.
Yeah. Like I tore a few out towards the end.
Thanks. Thank you very much. That was on my wish list, so hopefully I'll crack through that and review this at some point. Because the thing is, I looked at this and thought, yeah, I've actually not done... I've not read any fantasy book that just focuses on dwarves. And,
right.
And they're like a mainstay of fantasy. I guess you could say The Hobbit.
Yeah.
It's got dwarfs in it, but there is a main character, obviously, Bilbo Baggins. But there you go. Thank you very much.
And cracking on. Yay!
Hey.
Blade Runner 2. Blade Runner 2049.
2049.
Excellent. We saw this in the cinema, didn't we?
We did see it in the cinema.
Very good.
But it's good, isn't it?
Yeah.
It is good.
Yeah, yeah.
And I've watched
good.
It.
They did a good job. I was worried, but it turned out to be good.
I watched it, because I got it on DVD, obviously, pretty much when it came out. I've watched it at least twice more.
Oh, right.
And even then, it's like, I get more from it. It's
yeah,
one of those films
I need to try and find time to watch it again. But I kind of want to watch the first one again, because I've not watched that for a
That's
long
what I did.
Time.
I did a back-to-back.
Yeah.
I've
got the 10-disc box set of the first one with every version.
I've got that, yeah.
Shall we crack on and watch?
Let's crack
on. Get this film.
Yay.
Let's watch this film, because this looks much better.
Yay.
Shall we see you on the other side?
Let's see you on the other side. Let me just crack this open, though.
Woohoo.
Yay.
Christmas. Christmas. Most magical time of year.
Now tell me we will find the perfect Christmas tree.
It's Christmas. Christmas is all about forgiveness and family and tradition.
Santa, lots of kids are depending on tonight going off without a hitch.
But in Bailey Downs this Christmas, it's different.
Exactly 1 year ago, last Christmas Eve, the school was the scene of an unimaginable crime.
And you still want to go down there just for some stupid school assignment?
I could just do any door in the school.
This is Krampus, right?
What's a Krampus?
He's like an anti-Santa Claus. A demon who punishes the naughty. He whips them, chains them up, stuff like that.
That's fun.
It's the elves. I fear they may all become infected. How did it all come to this?
We're trapped down here, and there's a psychopath on our loose.
Bring the changeling back to the forest. That ain't his son.
Did you not see what he did?
The atmosphere here in Bailey Downs is truly grim this holiday season.
Scary? Wasn't quite.
Was it? Well, you tell me.
I don't know. A Christmas horror story. What did we
oh,
think?
Oh, don't we pick them?
You pick them. You see, I'm blaming you. No. Well, interesting. It's yes. Well, okay. Let's look at the box title then. A Christmas horror story. It was Christmas. There was Christmas
all
elements
set
in
Christmas.
There. Yeah. And it was horror. It definitely was horror.
Definitely some horror.
Story. I do have a problem with that.
Yeah, stories.
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 It seemed to be...
Confused us for quite a long
time,
didn't
it?
Wondered where it was going. Then we realised it wasn't really going anywhere.
It wasn't going anywhere.
For a while.
There seemed to be... You pointed out, actually, it's directed by three different people. I've got here, thanks Wikipedia, directed by Grant Harvey, Stephen Hobben and Brett Sullivan...
Yeah.
Three different directors. They turn out to be four separate stories.
Yeah.
But there was a clever twist at the end.
Well, let's not go there just
okay.
yet.
Let's not just go there just yet.
Yeah. Because, yeah, initial feelings were a bit... Okay, we kind of went, oh, okay.
Yeah, it was a good opening.
William Shatner popped up. Bosh.
The Shat.
Straight away.
Yeah.
That was interesting.
That was always a bonus.
So he sort of sat there doing his thing. Got paid for a day's work. And
yeah, exactly. He played a DJ. He linked the stories while we were going along. So
yeah,
we thought
it was cutting from scene to scene.
Yeah,
and we were establishing different
characters,
stories. Different groups of people. Yeah. So different little storylines.
Yeah.
Like films have.
Like they do.
And then you quickly soon wait how they all linked together
and
the main
yeah.
thing. These didn't, did they? They kept being separate. With William Shatner being a DJ, doing little DJ bits
yeah.
about Christmas. It's Christmas time. He's sitting there doing a late night show.
And I think it all took place in the same... Well, let's find out. Yeah, the
well,
same
no, not
town.
All of it. Because there was, then we discover Father Christmas is alive and well and real.
Yeah, and I love that opening because that was how it opened. It was the winter wonderland, the Santa's kingdom, or Santadom. And so you got elves. Elves are real. Santa's real, and that was good. I like that.
Yeah.
It was a good bit of fantasy element there.
But then we go to modern day.
Then we go to modern day. That's fine. Now I think the other three stories though were set in the same place. So it says here 2015 anthology horror film.
Well, so an anthology horror film. Okay.
It says here it had a limited theatrical release in October 2015, along with a VOD release.
Was just a few years ago.
I know.
It wasn't made like 10, 15, 20 years ago.
And it says here, the film is a series of interwoven stories tied together by a framework story featuring William Shatner as the radio DJ, who, incidentally, his character name, his DJ name was Dangerous Dan.
That's a good DJ
but
name.
But he wasn't dangerous.
No, he wasn't.
He wasn't dangerous. But we used to have a character, we used to know, we... Okay, I'm going to admit something. This is a time for admitting wrongdoing, is it? Ever.
Okay, here we go.
Well, when we were kids, okay, there was... He wasn't homeless, but there was a guy who was an old guy that used to shuffle around. He had a limp where we lived in in town, and he, we used to kind of follow him around, just right. see what he did, because he was quite a sad character. Yeah. Obviously, as an adult, we were idiots. Yeah, looking back, we were idiots. But as kids, as like 13-year-old kids,
curious,
we were curious, and we used to call him Dangerous Doug. So that's. Mm.
Oh, so there we go.
Yeah, but again, he wasn't dangerous.
And he wasn't Shatner.
No, it might have been.
Anyway.
Maybe.
This film, we haven't got time to go off on that crazy. This isn't an hour-long imp show.
It does say he's an alcoholic radio DJ, which you kind of get a...
He starts having a little drink because he's doing the late night slot, and he's full of Christmas spirit, isn't he?
But I didn't see him being an alcoholic.
He got slowly more and more drunk, didn't he? But I think we're focusing on the wrong bit, because that bit was just a little bit that linked... That didn't even link them.
No,
it was just a bit that was
them.
Put in between these stories. I was waiting for these stories, for some sort of thing to happen where we suddenly go, okay, they all come together, or there's one bad creature that's picking them all off one by one. Because we had the classic young teenagers trapped down. You know,
trapped in the cellar.
Yeah, or let's break into the school and do a news report.
Yeah.
Oh, hang on, let's go down to the cellar. Oh, we're locked in the cellar. Where are we? Let's explore. Yeah. Oh, the school used to be an old monastery.
Yeah.
All that unraveled.
There was two murders the previous Christmas. Yeah, so they're doing like a documentary about that.
Or a report on that.
Yeah.
But so you had these groups. So you had the classic horror groups of, you know, horny teenagers.
And you got a nice family. Dysfunctional
family who all didn't really get on very well on a journey to see the old aunt or something. So you find out about this family. None of those seem very nice people.
And then you think, oh, good, I hope they get
another family with a little kid who's celebrating Christmas, and they go to get a Christmas tree. They kind of steal a Christmas tree from a wood. They chop one down.
And he was a police officer.
But anyway, so you've got these different things. And in between each thing, it would cut back to William Shatner, the DJ. So his bit you could take right out, and it wouldn't make any difference.
Exactly. That's what I mean. There was a lot of it, I felt, that you think, right, if we took that bit out, wouldn't make a difference.
No.
You took that bit out, wouldn't make a difference.
But we're waiting. We're only halfway through the film. We're waiting for it all to come together.
Yeah.
Still wasn't coming together. Still quite slow for it to move forward.
I don't think they marked it out as these are going to be separate stories.
But the thing is, if we hadn't read this, we would have gone in not knowing. We went in not knowing it was separate stories. So it's confusing.
Yeah,
maybe we should have read the back of the box. It might have told us they were separate stories.
But I
like to think even if there's a film made up of separate stories, they all tie together
at some point.
Because that's the point. Otherwise, why not just... They're separate short films.
When we kind of worked that out near the end, we went, oh, hang on, maybe they are just separate
And then we went,
films.
Oh, four directors,
yeah,
three directors. Three different bits, or actually four bits.
Somebody did a bit more.
Yeah.
But what reminded me was the League of Gentlemen. Did you see a Christmas special? Now, I watched, it was brilliant, it was really good, and it did what they were trying to do, it was an anthology, but the way they did it was they had... The boozy swearing vicar in the League of Gentlemen. It's a TV show, British TV show, comedy, dark comedy, black humour, and they're heavily influenced by horror films and the writers and actors. And they had it where it was the sweary vicar, who is trying to sort of lock up really at night at Christmas Eve. She's sort of, you know, done what they had to do for the day or whatever, and she's closing up. But there's a person knocks on the door and says, "Please, I need your help."
Yeah.
And she listens to his story.
And you get a bit of a story.
And then you
get
the story.
Then you have another one.
Yeah, then he goes. Yeah. And then you get another character come in.
There's
then you
lots
get
of
his
films.
Christmas.
I can't think of now.
It's
called, famous film. There's lots of films like that which are linked. They're set quite clearly separate little stories.
Yeah.
They're not connected, but they're connected by this one character.
Correct.
Who does something.
But that's very carefully marked out.
Yeah.
This wasn't.
This was confusing.
Yeah.
It was a mess. I mean... There's too many stories for me.
This is as we
went through not knowing those separate stories, we're going, well, they're introducing lots of characters here, and we're having to follow these, and, oh, we're back to them, what happened to them, and then we're jumping back to them, and we're back to Father Christmas, which was actually the nicest.
I like that.
It looked like they chucked all their budget at the Father Christmas one, because there was lots of horror in there.
There was more
wasn't
horror
there.
In
it was
that,
obviously
yeah.
set in... in
and it
in,
was a little bit more interesting, I felt.
I want to say Neverland, but Neverland. Where
does
Father Christmas live?
He lives in the North Pole, doesn't he?
Somewhere there, what's it?
Well, Winter Wonderland.
No, it's called the Netherlands.
He's Dutch.
Yeah. Where does...
Lapland.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Anyway, he's a pole dancer.
That sort of story is nice. Wondering how that was going to tie in
with
this. Perhaps he's unleashed Krampus and that he onto the modern world.
Yeah.
Anyway, it didn't. And we established it was three unrelated stories.
Four, I think.
Started feeling that these aren't ever going to tie together.
Yeah.
And then they started wrapping up, didn't they? We're like, okay.
Okay,
they're completely unrelated, separate stories.
Yeah, and it flagged a little bit in the middle for me because of that.
A bit right at the beginning, if you're
really honest. Well, so for me, I think to improve the film, if I was going to do it, I would have gone, right, just maybe stick to one story.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
One story was good.
Yeah.
Lose Shatner. We don't need the Shatner element.
Well, or recast him in...
Or cleverly make that a part of it.
Yeah, clever that, actually... That
basically,
yeah.
I think you could lose the three stories that were set in modern time with the family, teenagers, Santa. And the other dysfunctional family. And just the Santa story. Because the others wrapped up and we were like, okay, well, that wrapped up. That was a sort of...
Yeah.
Christmassy, slightly horror, not much gore or anything, not much blood.
No, it was
in
more
any
suspense,
of those stories. Suspense.
It? Yeah.
They wrapped up and that was all a bit disappointing. All those stories a bit disappointing.
A little bit.
The
yeah.
Santa story then wrapped up last. And it was actually
a really good, clever
twist.
It was a really clever twist.
Clever, we won't say it.
We didn't.
I don't mind, yeah.
I didn't guess it. You didn't guess it, did you?
I didn't guess it at all.
No.
I didn't need the DJ element, I don't think.
No.
But you could have probably worked it in better if you wanted to.
You could have maybe cast
make the whole
Shatner
film,
as.
Yeah, maybe they did
Santa.
Just have that film and they went, actually, we can't stretch this to a film. That would have made a really good short film.
Yeah.
A really good short film.
Yeah, yeah.
A long film, it probably would have been a bit of milking, a bit too much milking. But you could do that for
no,
a horror.
But what you
for
could
an hour
have
and
done,
30 minute horror film, you could just do lots of gore, lots of adventure, lots of action.
Well, what you could have done was you could have had... Because it starts with a bit and then goes 12 hours earlier. So you still could have done that with that.
Sounds familiar.
And then you could have done, And then you could have done, say without trying... I don't want to give it away. Say it was William Shatner in that role, is what I'm saying. Yeah. You could have had his family life and then what leads him up to doing what happened.
Yeah, a bit more just exposition, a bit more background character.
Yeah.
You could have padded it out to a short action horror.
I reckon you could have done it to a feature film.
Yeah,
though.
I meant a short feature film, like an hour and a half, as opposed to a big old 2 hour.
Well, no, this was 95 minutes.
Yeah, so this was,
Which
But some
felt
good
longer.
Action horror films are quite like an hour 20, hour and a half.
Yes.
And not all 2 hours, 3 hour films. So
they
could have made a
good
film.
Well, 95 is an hour and 35.
Yeah, so just over an hour and a half.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, I'm saying this was, but I'm saying a lot of feature-length films are longer than this.
Too long.
But
yeah,
a lot of action movies are quite short. So I think it's pushing it to do anything longer than an hour and a half.
Oh, yeah, no. It would have been
perfect. But they could have done that
was,
story.
Yeah.
And maybe they felt they had to... Why they had to add these others? Because actually they ruined what would have been a really good film.
Yeah.
And they obviously had the budget for that, maybe.
Yeah.
By putting these other stories in that were completely unrelated.
Too
just
complex.
Confused it. Watered down the whole film.
Yeah. Or... You pick one of the other ones.
And if they'd had the Shatner twist, if they'd, without giving the twist again, but if Shatner was the main, Father Christmas, well, that's not giving it away, but no,
yeah,
kind of is,
that's what
but,
I'm saying. If it was a dip,
because that was a bit tenuous, that slight thing. I felt it should have been, and I think,
it should
don't
have been.
Watch this video if you've not seen this film, because there might be a spoiler in it, but without saying what the big twist is, if that was Shatner, you know, he had an evening job, a DJ, you know, whatever.
That would have been perfect because I would have bought into it because I bought into his character.
And he loses the plot.
And he loses the plot.
Has too many to drink.
Yeah. Perfect. That would have been really good.
Yeah.
And
it would have been a clever, good film. And it had lots of gore in it. It was a bit silly. It was a bit tongue-in-cheek.
Yeah.
Lots of elf splattering or whatever.
Yeah, there was elves. And it was obviously...
Yeah, why did they just shoehorn all these other storylines in? That was just ridiculous.
It says here, reception, Jake D from Arrow in the head... I don't know, is that a...
Rated the film? Aaron, must be some
Must
reviewer.
Be a reviewer, yeah, as in, I don't know, YouTube or whatever. But anyway, rated the film 5 out of 10, calling it overlapping segments uneven, and stated that the only final two segments managed to be memorable. Kind of go with that.
The final segment, final two? Oh, yeah. Yeah. Not bothered.
Brett Gullman from Oh The Horror offered similar criticism, stating the film would have been better if the segments had played separately, which is what I was saying.
Yeah.
Play it, wrap it up, play it, wrap it up, play
and
it,
then
wrap
just
it up.
Cut out the others and just go with it. Yeah, exactly.
Not all the reviews of the film, however, were negative. Brad Miska from Bloody Disgusting gave a film a positive review, writing, "While A Christmas Horror Story doesn't have the qualities of a big theatrical release, like Trick or Treat, it's glossy enough to bring joy to those, however, who end up seeing it." Jay Seaver from E Film Critic gave the film 4 out of 5 stars. That's I don't necessarily agree with that. Calling it a solidly entertaining piece of work. There we go.
I mean, yeah.
I would give it probably six.
It slightly redeemed
10.
Itself, but yeah, it kind of.
Because of that twist.
I think, yeah.
The twist was really good.
One bit of it was all really good if you ignore the others, but you can't because it keeps chopping it in. And as a film has got to be a film. We're sitting and watching a film from beginning to end, and they ruined it. They just ruined it by putting too much rubbish in it.
Yeah.
It's something that was actually a really nice little good
idea. I really want to just see that one.
Yeah.
Because I would have been, I guess out of all of them, I was more attached to the DJ, William Shatner character. Because he had a little bit of character, I was
wondering where that was going. Yeah, I was wondering when William Shatner was suddenly going to leave the studio and save the day by killing the main monster. But that was obviously clearly never an arc of that.
With alcohol.
Thrown in his face. Where he was going to. Yeah. Obviously just had a bit of money left over and went, let's just get William in for a morning.
Let's get a star in,
get a name attached
Maybe
to
Maybe he owed them a favour.
Yeah. But why would he be in a film like this? Because you'd read the screenplay and you'd go, that's got to be really confusing reading the screenplay, not even watching it.
Yeah, but I guess if I'm going to be brutal, maybe they offered him quite good money day's work, 2 days' work. Yeah. And to be honest, that actually isn't a bad part. It was not.
It was a nice little character for him. He could sit there, have some nice dialogue. He wasn't terrible. He wasn't.
No, I believed him. Yeah, I actually. Like we say, if he was the sort of main character and we'd gone back to see his family life and all that, I would have really, really enjoyed it.
But I wonder if that would have worked because we would have recognised him as because did that would that have mattered without
because,
trying to...
Because the twist ending, I believe it was a different actor to the...
That was the same actor. Yeah, but we hardly saw him. In the DJ thing, he was very quickly looked at in the shade with the sign.
Right,
but I don't know whether.
I think maybe you could.
I think
do
he
that
still
then.
Could have done it. That we know he's a DJ, and we also know he does a bit of because he's a DJ. He's a bit of a celebrity. Yeah. He plays Santa at the weekends.
Yeah, and then for the other bit,
it depends how you structure the.
I reckon you could have. Yeah, you could have heavily disguised him as Santa.
Yeah.
It would
I don't think it would have mattered if we'd known it was him.
Maybe not.
I'm just trying to think it through. I can't. Anyway. Yeah. We with a conversation for another day.
Yeah.
So that was.
That was a Christmas horror story.
Yeah.
So watch if you're at a loose end and you
I'd
can
say
track
watch
it down.
It and bear with it just for the payoff sort of at the end of one of the stories.
Yeah.
But
very clever.
Don't bother because there are plenty of other good films Not sure whether we should. No, I'm glad we picked that one though because I think the other two might have been.
Oh well, Hogfather.
Yeah, Hogfather might be.
That's Terry Pratchett.
But we like a Christmas horror here at the Imp.
We have been doing horror ones. Yeah. Well, I think that's the thing.
Oh, there was one good jump in it where we both jumped right at the beginning.
Yeah.
I don't normally jump at these things.
Really
I'm very quite
jump.
Hardened to horror films. But we both went whoa
because it lured us in nicely. But that was the only thing really. That made us
the
jump.
Rest was quite stereotypical classic horror film fare, you know, mirror in the bathroom. I don't think they did that one, did they? Change the mirror, so you know what I mean by that. They didn't do that.
Well,
one.
Like a character comes out of a door. There's nothing there. Character comes out
the
door.
Guy's standing there. He moves. The character's there.
Character
moves back.
Behind, moves back. It's
constant
gone.
Revealing and then disappearing.
Yeah, but again.
That's all tight, but you just put that in. It's fodder, horror film fodder. You put that in.
Yeah, it must be difficult.
We'll watch this DVD.
Make a horror film.
We should try and make a horror
fantasy horror film. But the thing about it is that
you need a good budget for effects because the effects are rubbish.
that's true.
And you know we've got a reputation for doing really good effects.
Of course we have.
Really, really realistic.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Good effects.
£3.50 is that the budget for?
Did we pay money?
I don't know. Ah. Yeah, well, for the Christmas Yule log.
Oh, for that's the Euro. That's where the budget went. I feel quite sick, actually.
Talking of that, though,
look. Christ, we didn't open the chocolate orange.
Yes, I'll have that.
This
I'll have that on Boxing
by
Day.
Chocolate. Well, that's not mine. It's been on my side of the table.
I know.
I'll Swapsy it. I've got this lovely thing.
Look, don't you want this? Come on. That's unique.
Yes, I love it.
That is. We're going to sell those if you want.
Would you buy
Christmas
this? It's got bottle in.
Yeah.
And it's got stars of the show. We've got to wrap this up, surely.
Let's do a Christmas cracker.
Is it a Christmas cracker?
Well, it's a Halloween Christmas.
That's not Christmas, is it?
That's
Halloween.
Well, it's a spooky
Halloween's a different
theme.
Holiday.
Is it?
Spooky? Oh.
Not in my town. Look at this. Right, here we go. What are ghosts' favourite kind of streets?
Quality streets.
because that makes sense.
Is that the answer?
Of course it is. Of course I got to do with ghosts.
Okay.
What are ghosts' favourite kind of streets?
Haunted streets, ghost spook streets, streets.
The streets.
The streets. I don't know what.
You'll kick yourself. Dead ends. And on that, bombshell.
You've been making puns throughout all of
I have.
Should we wrap this up?
Let's wrap this baby up. The toy wasn't very good. Anyway, what else? Is that it? I think we've done it, haven't we?
We've got to be at the end. What time is it on Christmas Day now?
Well,
we've missed the Queen's speech.
Ah, no. We'll have to watch it on
catch-up. Just got to eat stale...
But you don't eat turkey.
No, I don't.
Nutmeg roast.
Say nutmeg. Nutmeg roast.
It's what do you
yes,
have?
Ken.
I don't
we
know.
Have,
a vegetarian.
We have nutmeg roast.
What do you have?
Nutmeg
like lettuce.
Nutmeg.
Do you just have lettuce?
Just lettuce with nutmeg on.
And Ryvita.
Yeah. Sprinkle of nutmeg.
I don't know what it is. What's
we
it
eat pies and
nut roast.
Yule logs.
Nut roast.
Nut
thingy.
Roast.
What's it called?
Nut roast.
It's a nut roast.
We're having a
bush.
Corn roast this Christmas.
I used to be vegetarian. I was veggie, and then...
Well, it's not what we're going into a conversation.
Don't know.
How do we wrap it up?
This is our boozy ending, anyway. Just two old men rambling on. Anyway.
We should do this live next year.
Oh, yeah, we should do, shouldn't we? Should do it live on Christmas Day.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for watching. Remember to keep it unreal.
Have a great Christmas Day.
Exactly.
Are you watching this on Christmas Day? If you are... We're sorry. Sad,
yeah,
sad
you've obviously got no friends or family, just like us.
Oh no, but if you are watching
yes.
this, thank you.
Yeah, exactly.
We love our fans who watch this on Christmas.
Yeah, no, exactly. In all seriousness, thank you for watching. We like doing these. They're good fun. And we've got lots more stuff coming out next year, 2019, Julian.
Oh my God.
Where did the year go? It disappeared.
2019 hasn't happened yet. It's not gone yet.
That's
it's ahead of us. It's just up there.
No, that's what I'm saying.
It's just
next
up there.
Year. So we've got
2018?
Stuff. Yeah.
Where did that go?
Oh, I see.
It's only a few days ago.
Yeah. This is confusing.
2019, still
just
to
like
come.
The film.
What does it hold? Who knows?
Who knows? Who cares? Do you do New Year's resolutions?
I try to do something.
What,
try
have you got anything in mind?
To, well, I've not. I've got a few days to think about it, yeah? It's only the 25th of December.
Yeah, exactly.
This is filmed 6 months in advance.
It's actually June. It's really hot. We're really sweating.
Right.
That's something else.
We're
anyway, yes. Merry Impmas! Merry Impmas, one and all!